Hi everyone, and in this video we are going to talk about closures. So first of all, closure is actually a well-known term and everybody asks about what is closure, okay? And it can be understood with some example. So closure is the combination of function bundled together with a reference to its surrounding state. You can take an example of inner function, outer function, where inner function is able to access the scope of the outer function even when the outer function has already returned, means you have already called it by passing some argument in the outer functions, and that value is persisted inside the closure of the inner function. Okay, so if we take a look onto this example, here we will be able to understand closure. So what we are doing, we have a person function. Okay, the person function is returning a say function, and here you are able to access text. So if I just try to print console.dir and I will just remove everything else. Is it not printing it? I think we would not be able to get the inside body of the closure. That is fine. So this is the person object, person function. Inside that it is returning another function. So when you are calling this function at line this, it is actually returning the say function. Okay, it's like a curry function. One function is returning another function, so you have to call that again. So when we are calling it here, then it is actually executing the say function and it is printing text. So consider this. I'm passing the Pradeep as an argument in the while calling the person function, okay, and after that I'm calling object, and even I'm calling that as a separate statement, I'm still be able to get the value of text here using closure. Hello Pradeep, this will be the output I will be getting. So how that is possible, right? Using closure, hello Pradeep, this is the output we are getting. So how it is happening? Because when you call this function, you actually pass the Pradeep and you returned it, right? But with the help of closure, this inner function is able to access or able to store this outer scope variable, which is text, inside the closure of the inner function. So when you are calling the say function using this, so you can call it as an inner function. When you are calling inner function again, that inner function has the text property available. It is same as you have actually outer function, inner function, function add. So it's add B and it's add A. Right, so whenever you are calling add A by passing 3, I will just assign it to, and then I will be calling inner function by passing 4. Right, so inner function, this add B will persist this value of A inside the closure of it, because it is able to access the immediate outer scope even when the add A function has already returned. So finally it will have A and B both value, because the value of A is coming from the closure and B we are passing. Okay, this is the plain explanation of what closure is. Okay, thanks everyone.